Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this day, the privilege to always call on you, and then call on you based on your promises, written word. We ask that as we go through this session, your spirit will go through with us, and that you will bless us greatly today. We'll never remain the same again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We've been on our prayers for quite a number of days now. But we need to look at the Word of God to be the foundation of what we are praying on. And I'm asking God that He will grant us understanding of His Word in Jesus' name. Proverbs chapter 9, I'm going to read verse 10. Proverbs chapter 9, verse 10, it says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding." Here we see God being presented to us as the basis of all knowledge. That is, if you do not fear God, you are actually not wise, you are foolish. He said the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And so, if you want to show that you love the Lord, then you fear Him. But then what does this fear mean? We need to understand, this fear is not slavish fear, being a slave and so, I act as if I'm in bondage. No, that's not the fear. This fear is reverential fear. That is, you reverence God, you honor God, you adore God. The fear we are talking about is not a panicking fear. What makes you panic before God? No. What makes it pleasant fear, really? It's pleasant to fear the Lord. And so I'm going to describe this fear of God in three ways. First, it is a sense of respect, reverence, and awe for God. This fear is a sense of respect, reverence, and fear for God. That means you know that God is always with you. You are conscious of Him. You know He has the final say. He has the power. His presence is here. And He has the final authority on every matter. So go back to Proverbs chapter 3, verse 7. We see this fear of God. The fear of God. Be not wise in your own conceit. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. So this fear of God is what makes us to run away from sin. To depart from evil. So that's the first thing to note. Number two, this fear of God is the awareness of the loving Father with us. In two ways. Number one, that God is watching over us. He's taking care of us. Number two, this God is also observing, watching over our actions and inaction. And that we are going to give record of everything we do in this life to this God. You know, the message Jesus sent to the church in Revelation, if you look at it in Revelation chapter 2, you will keep hearing the word, "I know thy word. I know thy work." Let's see it again, just to emphasize the teachings of the scripture. Revelation chapter 2, verse 2. It says, "I know thy works." If you go to verse 9, "I know thy works." If you go to verse 13, that's speaking to different churches, but he kept saying, "I know what you are doing." Look at verse 13, "I know thy works." Look at verse 19, "I know thy works." Look at chapter 3, verse 1. "And unto the angel of the church in Sardis write, this thing saith he that has the seven spirit of God and the seven star, I know thy works." So he knows what we are doing. He knows what we are not doing. God is actually observing every detail of our actions. So when we are conscious of the fact that God knows, that's what we call the fear of God. Do you understand? So first, we reverence Him. We know that He's present with us. He has final power and final authority. And now we know that He knows everything we do. He's there. So we are basically conscious of the omnipresence of God. We are conscious of the omnipresence of God. And so that makes us to fear Him. So the fear of God means consciousness of God in that sense. Number three, to be conscious of this... let me say it in four ways now. If you can write the word fear vertically, it can help you. F in fear is to be conscious of the fiery judgment of God. To know that when God judges, He's going to judge in a very, 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 very tough way. So when we are conscious of the fact that God is going to judge all, the fiery judgment of God, that is for F in fear, we then fear the Lord. That consciousness of His judgment makes us to fear Him. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, you will see in verse 14, it gives us the record of that. Of this, verse 14, For God shall bring every work into judgment. So we are conscious of that. And with every secret thing, whether it be evil or whether it be good. So we are conscious of the fact that God is going to bring everything into judgment. So that makes us fear God. Now, E in fear is that we have evident, we are conscious of the evident nearness of Christ's return. We are conscious of the evident nearness of Christ's return. We are sure that he is going to come one of these days. And so because we know he's going to come one of these days, we are preparing, consciously waiting for him. And that gives us the fear of God. A in fear is that we are conscious of the all-seeing eye of God. We know that God is seeing everything we're doing, and it's also watching over us. And so, R in fear, we are conscious of the reward of every action and inaction. We are conscious of the reward for every Christian service we give or every good deed we do. So we know that there is reward for everything. So when we are conscious of the fiery judgment of God, we are conscious of the evident nearness of Christ's return, we are conscious of the all-seeing eye of God, we are conscious of the reward for every action and inaction, that makes us to fear God. So that consciousness of his omnipresence, is the consciousness of his omnipotence that he has all power, that makes us relax and trust him. The consciousness of his omnipresent, omnipotent, and omniscience, that he knows all things, make us to be conscious of him, and thereby we fear the Lord. I hope that explains the meaning of what it means to fear God. Now, this fear of God, you know, unlike when you fear other people, when you fear man, it makes you avoid the man, run away from God, no, for the man. But the fear of God makes us come near to God. It doesn't make us to run away from God. It just runs up, makes us run towards God. So that means it makes us run away from sin. That's why when we learn in that Proverbs chapter 3 verse 7, we see that when you fear God, you run away from sin. So that is basically what the fear of God does for us. Then another thing we can also say like is this. You know, fire, for example. We know fire is necessary, but we also fear fire. Now, when the Bible said in Romans, Hebrews chapter 12, verse 28 to 29, that our God is a consuming fire. Now, does it mean that we should be running away from the fire? No, we use fire to cook. We don't run away from it. We use fire to boil our meat, boil our food, and all of that. We don't run away. So, when we are in good, we use it for something good, we do not fear it. So it means then that as God is a consuming fire, he's not consuming us because we are not sinners. We are pleasing him. We are seeking to please him more and more. And so the people that fear God and run away from him, the Bible says the wicked flee when no man pursues. Those are the people that run away from God. But for us, we come towards him, we trust him, we believe in him. So that is actually what the fear of God means. To be conscious of God, to be obedient to God, to be submissive to God, to honor God, to respect God, to fear him in a reverential way, not fear him to be running away from him. I hope that explains that. Now, we want to pray on this day, that Lord, put your fear in my heart. And by that I mean, put your consciousness in my heart. By that I mean, write your word on the tables of my heart. And when you discover you are doing so, one, you will live free from sin. Two, the certain sin will never come back in your life. Three, you will live in confidence, absolute confidence of the presence and the power and the possibility to God Almighty. Close your eyes and let's pray. Begin to ask God for grace to serve the Lord, grace to fear the Lord, grace to follow the Lord, grace to trust the Lord. That God writes your word on the tables of my heart. Inscribe it there. Write it with the fire of the Holy Ghost, that your word will be in my heart. Stamp your image on me. Put your grace in me. Put your love in me. Help me, Lord, to reverence you, to honor you, to follow you, to fellowship with you, to be with you, to always move towards you, and never to run away from you. If you have prayed this prayer and you are serious about it, I assure you, according to the Spirit of God, more of the Spirit, more of the grace, more of his righteousness, more of his love, more of his truth, more of his consciousness, more of his presence, more of his power, more possibility through him and by his word, you will discover in your life. Father, I pray for as many that has listened to this and are praying along, that Lord, they want to love you. They want to serve you. They want to fear you. They want to follow you. Put your heart upon us. Your hands upon us. Stamp your image on us. Change us inside out. That will be more like you every day. We will love you so passionately. We will serve you so passionately. We will follow you so passionately. We will fellowship with you so passionately. We will give our all to you so passionately. And will not allow sin to separate us from you. That now that we love the Lord, now that we fear the Lord, now that your word is written in our heart, now that your fear is written upon our heart, we will not fear any man. Someone said, he that fears God need fear no man. We will fear no man, we will fear no circumstance, and will destroy by fear this day every walk of darkness. We are free to serve the Lord and free to be all that you made us to be. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. Something real, something deep is done. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. God bless you.